Hi everyone, thank you so much for joining us on this introductory series on building web APIs with ASP.NET Core. My name is Elsa Phillip, and over the course of the next few videos, our goal is to be able to give you the information that you need to be successful when you want to build web APIs using .NET. Now, if you're unfamiliar with .NET, maybe this is the first time that you're really starting to build stuff with it, I recommend that you first head over to the .NET website. Here on the site, you can get access to a lot of great introductory level video content that covers topics such as C#, ASP.NET Core, and even .NET Core. I think these three videos in particular will give you the prerequisites that you need to be successful in this series. Before we really dive into the conversation about building web APIs, I think it's important that we understand what are they. What are web APIs? And to do that, let's separate that term into two parts. We'll have the web part, and we'll also have the API part. Now, when we think about web, we usually talk about ways that we can exchange information with each other over things like HTTP or even a web browser. When we think about APIs now, well, API stands for Application Programming Interface. And essentially, those are collections of operations that you can invoke on a machine, either locally or remotely. Now, putting those two terms back together, and we get web APIs. Web APIs are operations that I can invoke over HTTP to be able to leverage the functionality that those operations provide. And I can use that inside of my application to really enhance the experience that I'm trying to create. Now, it turns out, regardless of the app that you're building, you can make use of a web API also. So whether you're building a mobile app or a desktop app or a game, you can do things like leaderboard tracking or, you know, managing contacts, looking up business information or recipe information. It also turns out that web apps can use web APIs. And web APIs could use web APIs too, which I think has a really cool dynamic to how we could put these applications together. Now that we've seen some examples of apps that could use web APIs, why don't we talk about examples of web APIs themselves? And within the Microsoft ecosystem, I think there's a few interesting operations we could look at. Microsoft Graph, for instance, is a collection of APIs that gives us information back about our M365 account. If you use Azure DevOps for your CI/CD, you can get information about your DevOps pipeline using the Azure DevOps API. Also, if you're interested in doing machine learning and adding that functionality to your app, you can use something like the cognitive services. And if you're building games, again, PlayFab is an interesting set of APIs that could do things like leaderboard tracking, you know, scoring and player management. Now, if some of this stuff sounds really interesting to you, and hopefully it does, stay tuned for the rest of the course where we'll really dive into the business of building web APIs using ASP.NET Core. In the next video, we're going to talk about HTTP, which I think really forms the cornerstone of how we can build our web APIs.